Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Save Like a Pro with Leah. How is everyone doing? Here in Chicagoland area, we have a kind of cold and snow is expected for next couple of days. Thank God I'm off, so it's all good. If you are one of my faithful subscribers, so much for continuing your support. And if you are one of my new subscribers, welcome to the channel. Hopefully you will learn some new things as we grow together. Today I'm going to talk about retirement. We all need to think about retirement soon or later. We all like to be young, of course. There is no question about that, but soon or later we all need to retire and we have to live in a budgeting. So we had to live in a comfortable lifestyle and how we can achieve that. I thought about retirement like 10 years ago, but in fact I just started 6-7 years ago, because I gotta pay a lot of bills and pay off my debt and stuff like that. So I took my time and I started my retirement. Nowadays, I invest in Transamerica, Vanguard, those type of things. And so far, it's going good. I enrolled in a Target Retirement Fund 2045. So which means I'm anticipating my retirement at the year of 2045. And hopefully the Vanguard or Transamerica or different companies, they invest the money in the different type of stock, and by the time I'm ready to retire, hopefully I will have enough income. Another question is, how much money you want to invest? For me, my employers match up to 6% of the whatever I put it in. So I try to put 6% or sometime a little higher. It depends on what I can afford it. But I will recommend everyone to start at least some type of retirement, and it's gonna help you in the long run. Another good thing about the retirement fund is tax exempt. You don't have to show the whatever money you are putting in the retirement account. You don't have to show it in the tax. So you can have a little tax advantage of that too. But when you retire, you have to show it, but which is not a bad thing, because when you retire, you won't have much income. So it's not a bad thing. But if you are, if you are over the age of 55, I think you can put up to 30% of your income. So if you are, instead of paying to IRS, you can put it in the retirement income and it will grow, grow good. When you invest in the, retirement fund, if you are not sure, always talk to a consultant. Don't put in the high risk investment, because low cap, stocks and stuff like that, it can go down quick, and then it's gonna be a problem. Then you will lose. So it might take many years to come back up. Instead of making quick scheme money, I rather put in a much stable account like a bond, treasury, or target retirement fund. Target retirement fund is a good thing, because it has a low expense ratio. You don't have to pay much money for the maintenance. So that's a good investment too. Another thing is, invest only whatever you can afford it. If you put too much money in the retirement, and if you want to buy a car or put a down payment for a house, if you borrow against the retirement fund, then there is a penalty. If you borrow any money against the retirement fund before 59 and a half, there would be a penalty. So I wouldn't recommend that. Unless you can afford it, don't put too much money in the retirement fund. It is good for the tax advantage point, but if you need to borrow against it, the penalties are pretty hectic. So be very careful with that. Like if you want to buy a home or car or, you know, or another investment. So, you know, just put it in your retirement fund according to that. Never ever plan to borrow against the retirement fund before 59 and a half. There is a penalty. You can keep the money in the retirement fund till 70 years old. After 70, you have to withdraw it or there is a penalty. So retirement fund is good. If in case, always make sure that you put a dependent when you enroll in a a retirement fund. Make sure that you put a dependent status in case if something happened to you, your spouse or kids or siblings or whoever you nominate, they would be able to get the money. You know, in case of death or something happened to you. So the government won't take over. So always make sure that you put a dependent status. I would recommend you to put like 2-3 dependent. Husband or kids or siblings. It's better to split between 2-3 dependent. Because if one person cannot withdraw it for some reason, at least other people there to claim, or if something happened to that person. Have a stable job, that's a good thing. But if you have other expenses, take care of that, then think about the retirement. Like I told you, never ever plan to borrow money against from the retirement. Whatever you can afford it, you put it in there. But if you cannot afford something, don't put too much and try to borrow against it, then you are going to lose a lot of money at the end. But it has a tax advantage, especially if you are paying a lot of money to IRS. With the retirement income, you don't have to, show it to IRS unless it's a Roth IRA. If you can, it's two type of retirement, regular IRA and Roth IRA. Roth IRA means they are taking tax upfront. So when you are retired, you don't have to pay tax. If you can afford it, you do it that way. Otherwise, go to the regular conventional IRA. So you don't have to pay tax now. When you take the money out, you pay tax. Told you early withdrawal or against the money, there is a hectic penalties. I wouldn't recommend that. They have a lot of good retirement people like Vanguard, Transamerica, Valik, different companies. You can talk to them and see which is the lowest expense ratio funds are and go with that. And it's always a good thing to start whenever you can. I wouldn't recommend any short-term retirement fund plan because like stocks and stuff like that, if you make money short term, then you have to pay a high penalty if it's less than a year. So always try to do the retirement for many years. Even the stock market go down, as long as you are putting in a stable and better retirement plans, it will come back up eventually. If you are close to retirement age, I would never recommend you to put it in aggressive stock or stuff like that, because you don't have much time to if you lose money, you don't have much time to gain it back. For videos you want me to put it together, and I will try to do that, and we all can learn together as a YouTube family. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, comment, share and like it. And I would like to hear from you. Thank you so much and have a great day. Bye.